Hey y'all, Adobe just released an exciting new update for Illustrator called Generative Color. Over the past few weeks, the internet has gone crazy over the new generative fill in the beta version of Photoshop, in which you can just make a selection and type a prompt, and Adobe Sensei, which is Adobe's artificial intelligence, will generate an image to fill the selected area with whatever you typed in the prompt. It's basically DALL-E inside Photoshop, and some of the results are really, really impressive. Now, a somewhat similar feature is coming to Illustrator, which uses AI to recolor your vectors. The new feature can be opened through the Edit menu under Edit Colors, and it's currently in beta and available on the latest public version of Illustrator. On the background, you're seeing some footage of me messing around and testing this new feature, and right now I have mixed feelings about it, but then again, it's a feature that's in beta, so it's likely that it will improve over time. And actually, it's not that I don't think it's good, it's just not good at following your prompt sometimes, but I guess that's an issue with all artificial intelligence generators at this point. And still, for large and complex illustrations like the ones I was editing in the background footage, it is still faster to generate 10 or 20 color variations until you get the colors close to what you want than to manually edit each color one at a time. I had some good results using simple and objective prompts like winter, autumn, soft pastel, or vibrant colors, but sometimes it's also cool to use more nonsense prompts like trippy disco lights. This new feature also seems to somewhat identify what the illustration is about. I don't know if that's just something I felt or if that is in fact true, but when you had something like a landscape, it was kinda harder to generate completely crazy or like super vibrant colors. It felt like the AI tried to somewhat make more sensible color choices and pick something that made sense to the illustration. That's not necessarily bad, but it is something that I'd like to be able to choose somehow in the future, whether I want generative color to be more realistic or just be allowed to go bonkers. Perhaps we could even have some sliders to guide Adobe Sensei somehow, like do we want our colors to be soft or saturated, light or dark, do we want low contrast or high contrast, things like that. It's also worth noting that you can add some colors to the prompt to guide the AI in the direction you want, so that's already a very cool feature, but again, I'd like to see more customizability implemented in the future. AI is definitely here to stay. I think it's a great, but also crazy and kinda scary time to be alive. But let's hope Adobe makes the right decisions regarding artificial intelligence and that these tools only come to us to enhance our artistic capabilities and make our lives easier. What about you? What are your thoughts on these new AI generators? What do you think about generative color in Illustrator and generative fill in Photoshop? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, check this other one right here. A special thanks to all my Patreon supporters who help me make high quality content like this one. More on how you can support the channel in the description down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye!